In this video, I will show you how to make this kind of design. The first part will consist of creating an artwork with Midjourney. We will start by creating an artwork with Midjourney. Midjourney is an artificial intelligence able to create very efficient artworks in a very short time. We will be able to take advantage of it in our future designs and to create infinitely. Midjourney is a channel Discord. It works in a particular way when we are in one of the channels of the Discord. We are going to ask the artificial intelligence in the search bar what we want it to represent us. For this, we have to write imagine prompt and then write our request. In my case, I asked it this landscape of a future exotic nature and mushroom with abstract shape, 16:9, 4K, photorealist. Our request is to be clear and as precise as possible to guide it in its creation. From there, he will create four proposals for us. We can choose to make variations. By clicking on V2, I asked him to create a variation from the second proposed visual. He then proposed me these four other variations. The one that I liked the most was the first one I asked him by clicking on U1 to upscale this last one so that I get it with a bigger size and more details. I just have to save this image and reuse it in Photoshop. For this second part, we will deal with the torn paper shape. We will start by creating a rectangular shape with the rectangle tool here, choosing a white background color and a transparent outline. Then we will center it on our image by selecting both layers and centering our selection here. In properties of our rectangular shape, we are going to be able to round off our corners a little. We are going to remove the rounding of our corners and set them to 0 pixels, which will make a right angle in the corners. We are going to pass to our paper texture. To do this, we're going to import our torn paper texture directly into our workspace and we're going to position and resize it so that it fits perfectly with our shape below. Once the texture is lined up on top, we'll simply Ctrl plus left click on the image of our layer. This will automatically create a selection area for our layer. By selecting our second layer, we will mask it by clicking here, add a mask of fusion to this zone. This will automatically take our selection and therefore the torn outline of our image. To inlay our texture directly into our layer, we are going to create a clipping mask that will directly insert our paper texture on our shape. Then we'll play with the blending modes and we'll try to find the one that works best. Linear light is the one that works best and we'll reduce its background opacity a little bit. And here we have a paper texture and cut out our shape. From here, we will add a new area to our image. We are going to make another shape again from the rectangle tool that we will draw and center on our image. We will round its corners to 50 pixels. And we will be able to import our image that we generated earlier with Midjourney. We will position it over our rectangle and create a clipping mask. We will resize it as we wish. We can see that the image is not correctly integrated into the ticket. We have selected our two layers and created a group within those layers. We will simply click on the mask of our torn rectangle and by pressing Alt plus left click, we will duplicate this mask and apply it to this group, which will automatically apply it to the whole group. Our image will be masked and torn. To make this effect more realistic, we will copy it and paste it over our group, then reposition it. Then let's make a clipping mask in our group, which will simply apply it to the area of our image. From now on, we can start adding more details. I'm going to add an outline around the rectangle that forms this image. We're going to duplicate our slab and put it in the exact same place. From here, we're going to modify the properties of our rectangle to apply a transparent background, but this time, a black outline that we're going to set at 5 pixels. We have our black outline around our image and I find that our image lacks a little detail. We will give it a little print effect. So for this, we're going to click on our layer, drag and drop it here, which will duplicate it in the same place. So no need to reposition it. Then in we go to Filter, Filter Gallery. A tab will open and we will select Halftone Pattern, which will create this print effect that we can adjust here. So the size will be the size of the dots and the contrast will be the sharpness of the dots that are created. This will have an effect that is black and white, but I want it to blend in with the color of the layer below. In the blend modes, we're going to come in and select a mode that will blend the two layers together. Soft light. We can see that the two layers are merged and we have this print effect to make our texture stand out a little more. We will add a layer of brightness contrast, and by reducing the contrast and increasing the brightness, we will be able to bring out a little more color and texture of our paper. We will touch up our paper texture so that it stands out a little more by increasing its background opacity so that it is more realistic. Once we are satisfied, we can move on to adding graphic details. We will simply add our assets inside our group that has been masked, to which we have applied a texture with a clipping mask. This way, all our elements will be textured with this layer. Once we have placed all our elements, we will select all our layers, form a group, duplicate it, hide the previous group so that we can come back to it and make changes if necessary. Then, with a right click on our duplicated group, we will convert it into a dynamic object. We go to Filters, Camera Raw Filter, to refine the details of our image. Once it's okay for us, all that's left to do is validate. If we don't like our filter, we can always come back here by double-clicking on the Camera Raw Filter panel, which will reopen and allow us to retouch as we wish. We just have to add a little detail, this transparent plastic texture. And our design is ready. I encourage you to subscribe to my channel to support my work and discover my next creations.